The word is, it is the hottest ever the Garden was. Over 97 degrees, the air conditioning's broken. So, Danny, what was it like going into this game or being in this game with the heat, which everyone seems to be talking about?
Yeah, I mean, it was we were used to the Boston Garden. Obviously, it had never been as hot as it was that night, and especially with all the fans in there. But listen, we've all played outside in 100 degree temperatures and humidity, and you know, it's a game five. You know, like I don't think it really bothered us at all. I know there was a lot of talk about it and a lot of hype on television about it, but we didn't really talk much about it or even think that much about it.
Now, a lot of the talk comes, the Celtics pick up their physicality, and that's backed up by images of Rambis going down with heart fouls. Did you guys do other things that were different in this game that really changed things?
Well, I'll tell you a funny story about that hard foul on Mikhail. We're watching game three, and they're just a fast break lay-in drill. And, you know, I was a defensive balance guy because I was usually at the three-point line, so I'm running back, and I got Magic coming down the middle of the lane, and I got Worthy and Byron Scott on both sides that can touch the top of the backboard, and I'm, like, stuck in between these, and I'm getting booed in every arena because I'm the only guy on the team that will take a hard foul. And so after the meeting, everyone's going like, we got to start fouling. Like, this is ridiculous. We got to. And I looked at Kevin and go, like, why don't you foul somebody one time? Why don't you take a hard foul once? And anyway, we sort of went back and forth, and there was a lot of bickering. But our team was not happy after game three. And Mikhail did that. That got us kind of fired up. Not because of a hard foul against Rambis, but it wasn't Larry who did it. It was Kevin. And that was, I think, got us even more geeked up. Like, yeah, Kevin. That was my favorite play Kevin made in his whole career.
Was that out of his character to do something like that?
Yes, completely out of his character. Kevin's been apologizing that ever since he did it.
All right, so we're going into this game five. The temperature is hot. You guys are starting to get back. Now, the Garden, I always feel like the Garden's magical in the playoffs. And I know, obviously, it's a different building back then. But did you feel the same thing? And what do you think is that magic? And what is it that the crowd does that creates these unbelievable environments?
Well, the Boston crowd is just, you know, it's just a fun crowd. I mean, they're really close in the old Boston Garden, so it feels like they're right on top of you. There's smoke up in the top balcony of the arena. And it just was an old school gym. I mean, you know, a little bit like Fenway Park is and, you know, LA was all glitz and Hollywood. And, you know, we were all about blue collar, and the crowd, the fans were kind of crazy and nuts. And I think there was a little bit of an intimidation factor about our crowd. But the support, you know, they were always there and they were loud and they wanted us to beat LA in the worst way. Like, we could not let LA come into our place and win. And that would have been bad. Like that happened in 1985.
Yeah. Speaking of that, you know how pivotal game five is. Do you guys talk about this game has to be won, or is it pretty much, hey, we know the deal here. We got to win. We're at home. It's game five. We got to get this thing done.
Yeah, like I said, you know, we knew these guys were great. And, like, we had to play great. It wasn't like we just got to go out and win and will our way to win. Like, we had to really lock in, make shots. You know, we had to play really well if we're going to beat this great Laker team.